without you guys being here, it can't be, you know, successful. So thank you all. I wanted to just kind of relay, this is like the same audience from the Masterpiece, right? Except a few people, so I'm gonna tell another story briefly. When I was 16 years old in the prior century, I don't remember if it would have been, it must have been Richie that brought them in, but the Dallas Brass came here. They played the Satellite Student Union, and a buddy of mine in high school, who was another group player, who drove up, I think the band, our band director coordinator brought us up here. And I never heard anything like, you know, a professional level ensemble like the Dallas Brass. I remember just being, you know, like the sophomore in high school, being like, wow. How? You know, I had all these questions. I'm like, what do I do? You know, and then I got lessons and stuff because I wanted to improve myself. But that experience as a student was very impactful for me. And it's been one of like my missions to make sure that that sort of continues. And my predecessor, Michael Caldwell, started the Trumpet Festivals before I was here. And I've been keeping it going. But the whole idea is that we all are inspired. I am certainly inspired by Mr. Hooten today. And so I hope you all leave this event feeling that way as well. And I just want to let you know, so he has a brief, like 15 minutes or so after to say goodbyes and greet you guys for a little bit. But then he has to get off to Los Angeles for rehearsal tomorrow morning. So I just want to let you all know that. So we can all hang for a little bit after the concert. Without further delay, I'd like to introduce Tom.
Yeah. questions and sort of enthusiasm I could feel from even today's both classes, from a bigger class at large and then the trumpet class. It's always fun and scary and everything under the sun. Those of us that, you know, play recitals, those of you in college that are going to play recitals, it's a mixed bag, right? You're excited, but you also want to sort of run screaming off stage. But I love doing these. It's such a growing experience, and it's also an opportunity to sometimes play stuff that you haven't played before. The first one, obviously, I played that for a long time. This next one, by Cecilia McDowell, is fairly new to me. It's a sort of collage of different paintings that inspired these movements. There's two movements that we're not doing. It's called Framed. There's two movements that we're not doing, a little bit for time, because we had one rehearsal. But I want to tell you a little bit of description about each one. Unfortunately, I didn't arrange to have paintings, but it might be interesting for you to either play this piece. It's very accessible for collegiate level. It might be a really nice recital piece that you could use to augment your recital. This first one is called Ball at the Moulin de la Galette. This is Renoir depicts an elegantly dressed men and women who meet to chatter, drink, dance in the warm glow of the well-loved Parisian dance hall. By a Dutch painter, Everton. this is like a wintry scene. It's kind of from like, imagine somebody from the top of this auditorium looking down on a bunch of people skating. You all know what the hurdy-gurdy is? It's like an old instrument. How would you describe the hurdy-gurdy?
It's like a drone or organ type thing, again, grind.
Yeah.
And one long note.
What's that?
One long note.
One long note, but like, it was stuck over the top of it. I kind of think of this in a way, it's kind of like nostalgic, but at the same time, the perspective of the viewer into the painting is from the hilltop. So I sort of hear a little bit of nobility or sort of something that's like a special or kind of unique. Controversy on both sides of what it was like to be a sex icon, what it was like to be a woman, what it was like to be a professional in terms of some other sort of, as an actress. And in this music, there's times when it's sort of like loose, sort of like the song depicts. And then there's other times where it's kind of strict, where it sort of feels there's a little bit of play there between which role do you want me to be in, hence the 50 faces.
large church.
Thank you. the QR code in the group chat. Send it to me then.
Thank you.
sounds good because you don't rehearse as much until you get to the recital, and then you're like, why am I doing that? I don't know anything about that. This Adolphus Hellstor, anybody know this composer? Just a couple of people, okay. There's a couple of pieces out there that I think of orchestra, but I've enjoyed learning this piece. And he was a violinist, and some of the stuff actually sounds kind of like it would lie easy on the violin, but maybe not so much trumpet. But in the little research that I've done about him as a person, he's kind of a character, maybe not taking himself too seriously, which I think you'll hear in this piece. It also has a middle section which I think evokes a little bit of his African-American roots in terms of some of the music that may be inspired. I hope you enjoy Variations for Trumpet.
Thank you.
excited to play for you. 99% of you probably have never heard of this piece, right?
Right, yeah.
Right, okay. So, Pretty Feet, or Pretty Feet, I guess, depends on where you come from. this is like a fixed dish. And Jeff Stradling is a LA composer. He does a lot of TV and film, a lot of arranging, a lot of orchestrating for the movie and TV business, TV industry. And this was several years ago, and this happens from time to time. I just got a random email. Hi, my name is Jeff Stradling, and blah, blah, blah. Check out this piece I wrote. And you know, a lot of times you listen and you're like, eh, not that great. I listened to this and I about blew my top. I was like, this is so cool! And he just sent me a MIDI file that was kind of, you know, rough. It just sounded like a musical. But this is really unique. So this piece, the Prefeat, is several different dishes. Help me out here. So the first one, amuse-bouche, is sort of like a gift from the chef. You know, you ever go to a fancy restaurant, it's like, here, this is from the chef, a little tiny thing. The next one is sort of like